around our side. In my mind, 'cause sometimes I look in her eyes, and that's where I find a glimpse of her eyes.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's season 22 of The Voice, my 7th season on The Voice, and we have brought back a classic. They said we would be canceled, but we haven't been canceled yet. Woo! It's Trailer Talk, yeah! Everybody! Yeah! The main reason we haven't been canceled is because it only airs on my Instagram, and who's gonna cancel me but myself? Anyway, we're here, and we have a very special guest. You might recognize her laugh in the distance, but she is the newest coach on The Voice. She is multi-talented. She's a superstar. Aww. She was on a previous competition show that did get canceled.
Yeah, boo. Just kidding. Thanks, X-Factor.
She did well. She did well on that show and then was part of a very successful group called Fifth Harmony.
Yeah.
But the world needed to hear her singing solo, doing her own thing, and she has been taking the world by storm in her solo career. Please make some noise for Camila Cabello!
Yay!
Hello, my dear.
Hello, darling.
All right, now, folks, you may have seen Camila as my advisor on Team Legend last season, but she was so good at that everybody here at The Voice, all the producers, everybody fell in love with her, and they, when they had an opening, they said, we've got to ask Camila Cabello to come to the show. So Camila, how are you doing? Are you enjoying your experience on The Voice?
Yeah, I'm happy to get to spend more time with you on here because we had so much fun that day.
It was so fun.
It was the first time we properly hung out.
Absolutely, we had so much fun. You coined a very famous term called legendary behavior.
Oh my God, wait, yes you're right.
It was coined on that day.
Yes, you're
right.
And
it's been used a few times since, but always credited to you.
I mean, there's so much you could do with your last name.
Yes, we're gonna do more with it. My new album's called Legend. We're just leaning into it.
About time.
We're leaning into it.
I actually can't believe you haven't done it before.
I know, I just feel like now's the time, you know? I'm ready to lean into it.
Yeah.
But anyway, this is not about me, this is about you. You're here, you're on the show. Are you having fun with your artists and everything? Is it going well?
I'm having a lot of fun. I was really, you know, the other day we did our group coach performance and I turned to you and I was like, wow, there's a lot of things that you don't expect. Like there's the part that you expect, which is like, I'm gonna feel the fulfillment of getting to see people grow, of getting to all the things that I tell myself before a performance, before I do a session, I get to pass that on to somebody else and see how they integrate it and how they grow.
Yeah.
But I didn't expect the growth that I feel from just talking about music all day long. Like I was
Absolutely.
Like, oh, this is making me a more conscious performer, a more conscious singer. And that's the part that I'm also, I guess, selfishly, like, really excited about, too. Have you felt like that?
The reason why you feel like that is because you're basically being an A&R in some ways for these artists.
Right.
And what it does is helps you think about your own A&R process in a different way and helps you kind of look outside of yourself and think about it as a coach and as an audience member, how the work that you're doing is. Is it being effective and is it doing what it's supposed to do? And I really think it helps me to be a better performer being a coach on The Voice. And so that's what you're feeling right now.
Yeah, and you're also seeing so many different kinds of performers and so many different kinds of energies.
And you're learning so much more new music too.
I'm learning so much new music and you're also being a student too of like, oh, that person's doing too much on stage. Oh, that person has a they're very composed and take things very slow. Oh, I can see myself not doing that. I gotta integrate a little bit more of that.
Absolutely.
So that's really
exciting. It's growth for us too.
No, totally.
I always tell people it's inspiring for me and I actually learn a lot and I grow a lot on this show. So when you think about having been on another competition show, we joke about you mentioning that, but it's true and it's a very relevant experience.
Yes.
And so what do you think that you learned from that experience that carries over to what you're doing now?
I think the biggest part is the psychological tricks, especially for the younger people on the show, the managing your emotions part, because, oh my God, I forgot that there's like an audience here. Hi, guys.
Hi, audience.
I feel like I'm on a talk show. I feel like being on that show, you have to really block out the fact that there's people watching. You have to block out the pressure and really mm-hmm. remember what it's about for you.
So I think you're in a good place to be a good psychological coach for them, because you've experienced this like none of us have.
Yeah, and I think that when you're 15, 16, like for the younger people, and even for the more adult people that have no experience performing, for a lot of people it's so easy to get in your head. Mm-hmm. And I think also like in our culture, there's so many different ways of dealing with that pressure, you know, and I tried so many of them. Like there's the way that's like, you know, you gotta go out there and you gotta crush and you gotta kill. Mm-hmm. And sometimes I found that that didn't work for me. Sometimes the reverse psychology of, you know, go out there and be yourself. And if you make some mistakes, it's okay, because what really matters is about kind of being in your body and the kind
yes.
of the more spiritual part of really feeling your feelings, as mm-hmm. opposed to when you're thinking about how to give a technically perfect performance, that's when the disconnection happens.
Yes.
And I think, yeah, sometimes I think culturally you can get so stuck in the rigidity and the pressure and the perfection that it can mm-hmm. kind of trip you up. I see that happening with the artists a lot. So I think the mental health aspect is something that I think I have a big
yeah.
advantage with, because a lot of people I feel like got famous or were in these situations when they were already grown, when they were 27.
I was, yeah.
Right. And I was 15. So it was honestly, even recently, I think I'm processing how difficult that was.
Well,
for me.
And this season, you know? We have a lot of teenagers.
A lot of young
people.
We
have more teenagers this season than we've ever had since I've been on the show.
Yeah.
So this, I feel like, is the best year for you to give them that kind of
yeah.
advice, because you really do remember what it was like to be them.
Yes.
And some of them are, one of them is like 13 on the show this
yes.
season, but we've got 15, 17, 19, and there's a lot of young people, and we just want them to take this experience and make the most of it, but not be overwhelmed by
yeah.
the mental aspect of it.
Yeah, and I remember actually talking to my therapist like before I came mm-hmm. on the show, and having that intention of wanting to be like an advocate for that artistic integrity piece of it, and like the psychological integrity
mm-hmm.
of it too, where it's like you want to make sure that you're being yourself. I don't want to tell you what to do. I
mm-hmm.
want to make sure you're happy and that you're enjoying and having fun, and you're not, you know, because I notice even with a couple people on my team, I see a lot of myself in them, in that they really overthink and then they trip themselves up on
yeah.
stage. And people that are really talented, where I'm like, your self-talk is actually getting in the way of how you perform.
Well, they're lucky to have you as a coach.
Thanks.
Let's talk a little bit about your career right now. You're doing amazing things.
Thanks.
And you've been so successful. And I think what you've tapped into is understanding that your cultural heritage
yeah.
is your superpower. And you're
yes.
able to like translate that into the pop music realm in
yeah.
a way that really works so well. So talk about that.
I mean, I think that I'm so lucky to have been, I mean, I guess, born speaking another language,
mm-hmm.
and my mom is Cuban, my dad is Mexican, and I lived between those places for a while. And even growing up in Miami, I'm so lucky to have access to not only Cuban and Mexican culture, which is so rich musically, and the way the people are and the food,
mm-hmm.
like in every aspect, film and literature in every way so rich, but because of the language, the broader Latin American culture.
Mm-hmm.
And then even in a broader sense, I feel like I'm so obsessed with learning different languages and like learning French and Italian and, you know, listening to music from different places. Like, you know, I'm like obsessed with Afrobeat, and like
mm-hmm.
I want to listen to French music and music from Brazil, because I know what a gift it is.
And it's so interrelated with Latin American music,
yes.
like African music. All of these musics, you know, they have similar roots and
totally.
Lots of connections, and you feel the rhythms and the
totally.
Similarities between the rhythms. And I love how you're just embracing all that and making great pop music from it. It's
Thank
amazing.
You. And it benefits my life so much
yeah.
too, because it's just, it's so inspiring. I feel like that's like one of the things I'm most thankful for, is that I feel like I know how richer your life is
mm-hmm.
when you allow yourself to really see the beauty of how big the world is.
Yes, and music is better because of it.
Yeah.
Our culture's better. Everything's
yep.
better.
Everything's
and your career is awesome.
Thanks.
It's going so well. We're gonna sing a song together. Now, when I asked her to be on the show, I said, We can sing anything. We can sing one of your songs, but we could also just do a cover of a song that you're really feeling right now. And you picked a song that you're really feeling right now.
Yeah.
Tell us about it.
This is a song that my guilty pleasure is, and I only say guilty because I try to spend time, I try to not spend a lot of time on my phone, but TikTok is the rabbit hole for me.
Okay, guilty pleasure, TikTok. I get in there sometimes.
I don't know how you feel about it. It's my favorite form of social media because it's just, it does improve my sense of humor, I feel like. People are so creative on there.
Yes, there's a lot of really interesting creativity on there, things that make you laugh. The algorithm gives me a lot of comedy because I kind of stay on it.
Oh, me too.
Yeah.
Comedy is my...
Yeah, and I get a lot of just really good singing, so I get a lot of comedy and singing. Those are
cooking?
Like... I don't get a lot of cooking.
Me neither.
Yeah.
I get
pretty girls dancing because I stay on the video long enough. So
Yeah.
They're like, you like that too.
Me too. I get a lot of that too. I get a lot of Bad Bunny stuff.
Ah, makes sense.
Yep.
Makes sense.
I get a lot of that. I'm a stan. But anyway, so this song kept coming up, the chorus of it, Glimpse of Us by
This
Joji.
One doesn't come up in my algorithm, but I've heard this song as I've just been listening to music, especially thinking about songs I wanted my artist to sing. And then when you brought it up, I was like, oh, I've been listening to this because I was thinking about having one of my artists do this, but we're going to do it.
Yes. Wait, can I tell you the funny TikTok that I saw in relation to this
We should
song?
Tell them the name of the song, I guess.
Oh, yeah, Glimpse of Us by Joji.
Glimpse of Us by Joji. So tell me.
So I was telling Patrick and I were listening to this, my makeup artist, we were listening to this for like an hour, and there was this TikTok that I saw that was like me washing my eyes so he can't see a glimpse of them in my eyes.
I get it.
I just thought it was so funny.
I get it. So the whole song is about how you're with someone new, but you keep seeing that person
that
you were with.
Totally.
And it's really beautiful. I actually wrote with some of the guys who wrote this song on my new album. We have a new song called Wonder Woman. It's just really beautiful.
Can you please play it for me today?
I'll play it for you today.
Okay.
It's gorgeous.
Okay.
Anyway, we're going to do Joji's song, Glimpse of Us. It's really beautiful.
Sometimes I look in her eyes, and I swear I find a glimpse of us. And I try to fall for a touch, but I'm thinking of the way it was. Said I'm fine, I said I move on, and I'm only here passing time in her arms, hoping I find a glimpse of us.
Tell me, he savors your glory. Does he laugh the way I did? Is this a part of your story, one that I had never lived?
Maybe one day you feel lonely, and in his eyes you'll get a glimpse. Maybe you'll start slipping slowly and find me again. When you're out of sight, in my mind. Cause sometimes I look in her eyes, and that's where I'm a glimpse of us. And I try to fall for a touch, but I'm thinking of the way it was. Said I'm fine, and said I move.
Camila Cabello, everybody!
John Legend!
Thank you! That was amazing.
My heart is still hurting from that song.
The pain in that song.
Ouchie, ouchie.
Thinking about your exes.
Love you.
Love you. Great job. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, everybody. See you next time on Trailer Talk.